It works, I think, yeah. All right, everybody, let's come on up. We're going to get a little word of prayer before we open up. Let's go, guys. Come on. If you want to pray with us, you can. We love the Lord. Thank you, guys, for all your support and prayers for Truman. We had a great revival in Truman. You'll hear some testimonies about that revival later on in the service today. So let's go before the Lord in word of prayer, guys. Dear Heavenly Father, God, as we come before you, Lord, we thank you for this opportunity to come into a place, lift up our hands, and worship your name. God, we pray for a special anointing in this place this morning. God, we're not here for any other reason than to exalt and to lift you up. God, touch your people. Open up our ears that we may hear, our eyes we may see. And most importantly, God, give us a heart of comprehension. Holy Ghost, you are welcome in this place. Come in and take up residency. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. All right, let's have a great service. Ready? Here we go. All for one and one for all. Jesus. All right. Testing. 1, 2. Really weak in the monitors. Testing. 1, 2, 1, 2. Oh, man, that sounds weird to me. Testing. 1, 2, 1, 2. Test. Is it okay there, Jack?
Yeah.
You okay? Can you hear? Good. Because I lose you up here. I'm only going to hear my monitors here. All righty. Let's go before the Lord. How do we sound? Audio. Are we okay on audio? God bless you on this beautiful Sunday morning. Who loves the Lord this morning? Oh, come on. We can do better than that revival for Christ. We want to welcome you this morning. Who's ready for a God encounter this morning? We want to welcome you to the club this morning. Revival for Christ Club on a beautiful Sunday morning. Jennifer, it is wonderful to be back home with all the wonderful folks here. Good to have each and every one of you. Good to have you if you're with us on live stream. We had a wonderful time in Truman, Arkansas. Say hello to Brother Jason, Sister Shelby, Brother Eddie Lapiro, and Brother Chris, Pastor Chris. We had a great time in Truman, Arkansas. The spirit and the anointing of God flowed, and we had a wonderful time. But it is good to be back home. Who came into this house to praise the Lord? Oh, come on, church, I can't hear you. Who came into this house to praise the Lord? Let's go before the Lord in a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, God, as we come before you, God, we ask you to bless the service this morning. God, let your anointing and your spirit flow with freedom and with liberty. God, open up our hearing that we may hear, our eyes that we may see, and a heart of comprehension. God, we give you all praise, honor, and glory, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody said, all right, praise the Lord. Let's get ready to have church this morning. Lift up your hands. Lift up your hearts. Let's praise the Lord.
Yes. Hallelujah. Are you ready to praise him, church? Did you come to bless his name and allow his anointing to flow? Hallelujah. Spirit breaker, break all walls down. Spirit breaker, heaven come down. Spirit breaker, hallelujah. You want the Holy Ghost to have his way today. Come on and yield your vessel. Father, have your way, Jesus. We yield to you right now. Holy Ghost, have your way. revival, Father. Set us in that place, God, to change. Set us in that place, God, for transformation. God, set us in that place where we're yielded to your spirit, where we're yielded, Father, ready to be the vessels you've called us to be. Come on, somebody, praise him. He's worthy. King Jesus, you're the name we're lifting high. Your glory shaking up the earth and sky. Revival. We want to see your kingdom here. We want to see your kingdom here. King Jesus, you're
fade away.
Jesus, we worship you, Father. You will never fade away. Your love is here to stay by my side in my life, shining through me every day. Jesus, you will never fade away. Your love here to stay. Shining through me every day. You will never fade away. Your love here to stay by my side. You're in my life, shining through me every day. Lord, you will never fade away. Your love in my life. Forever, 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 you're in my life. Forever, forever, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Forever in my life. You will never fade away. Father, I thank you that you're by my side and that you're in my life, God, that I can rely on you, God. I can turn to you. I can worship you, God. You alone are worthy, Father. In this place, God, be glorified. I worship and adore you. I hunger for you. I search my heart. I want to remove everything that's not like you to be the vessel you've called me to be. Purge me with hyssop that I can be clean. Lord, I worship you. I adore you, Lord. Come on, somebody. This is a new era. You got to have a new worship in your heart. Hallelujah. Letting go of everything. Jesus, increase in me. Increase in me, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Father, we worship in this place. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Father. Come on, somebody worship him. He alone is worthy of all praise. He called up Abba Shutanamas. Hallelujah, Father.
I just want you.
I just want you.
I just want you. Find favor.
desperately waiting to be where you are. Across the hottest desert, I'll travel near or far. Lord, if I find favor in your sight, Lord, please hear my heart's cry. I'm desperately waiting to be where you are. Across the hottest desert, I'll travel near or far for your glory. Woo! I will do anything just to see you and to know you as my King. For your glory, I will do anything just to see you and to know you as my King. Lord, if I, Jesus, find favor in your sight, Lord, please hear my heart's cry. I'm desperately waiting to be where you are. I'll walk the hottest desert, I'll travel near or far for your glory. I will do anything just to see you, to behold you as my King. For your glory, I will do anything just to see you, to behold you as my King. I want to be where you are. I gotta be where you are. I want to be where you are. I gotta be where you are. For your glory, Jesus, I will do anything just to see you, to worship you as my King. Jesus, to behold you as my King, for your glory. Come on, somebody, worship him. I will do anything. everything that I have that's not like you, God. I will give it up just to see you. I want to worship you face to face, to behold you as my key. Come on, somebody. For your glory, I'll give it all up for you, God. I will do anything just to see you, just to worship you face to face, just to know you as my King. I want to be where you are. I gotta be in the corner of my seat. I wanna be where you are, in your presence, Father. There's fullness of joy. I gotta be where, come on, somebody. I wanna be where you are. I gotta be where you are. Come on, church, worship. I gotta be where you are. Where you are. Lord, if I find favor in your sight, my God. Lord, please hear my heart's cry. I worship. I'm desperately waiting to be where you are, that sweet place of worship. I'm desperately waiting to be where you are. Across the hottest desert, I'll travel near far. For your glory, I will do anything just to see you, to behold you as my King. Where you are, in your presence, God. I gotta be where you are. I wanna be where you are. I gotta be where you are. I wanna be where you are. I gotta be where you are. I wanna be where you are. I gotta be where, in your presence, God. Come on, somebody, worship. I wanna be where you are. I gotta be where you are. Thank you, Jesus. For your glory, I will yield everything just to see you, to behold you as my King. For your glory, I will do it. just to see you, to behold you as my King. I want to be where you are in your presence, Father, where there's fullness of joy. I've got to be where you are, created to worship you. I want to be where you are. I gotta be where you are for your glory. I will do anything just to see you, to behold you as my King for your glory. I will do just to see you, to behold you as my King. I want to be where you are. I gotta be where you are. I want to be where you are. Come on, somebody, worship him. There's a sweet spirit in this place. The Spirit of the Lord. There are sweet expressions on each face. And I know that it's the Spirit of the Lord. Sweet Holy Spirit, sweet heavenly dove, stay. With your love, and for these blessings, we lift our hearts in praise. Without a doubt, we'll know that we have been revived. When we shall leave this place, sweet Holy Spirit, sweet heavenly dove, stay right here with with your love and for these blessings we lift our hearts in praise. Without a doubt we'll know that we have been revived when we shall. Come on, somebody. Come on and worship him. Sweet Holy fill us, yeah, with your love and for these blessings we lift our hearts in praise. Without a doubt we'll know that we have been revived when we shall leave this place. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, somebody, you ought to have a worship. Somebody ought to have a praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord. Everybody lift up your hands. Let's begin to worship the Lord in this place tonight. He's worthy to be praised. Amen. Come on, lift up Jesus. He's worthy. He's worthy to be exalted. Worthy to be lifted up tonight. I don't care where you are or what you're doing. Right now, stop everything and set your mind upon the Lord. Lift up your heart and say, here am I, God. God, let your anointing, let your spirit begin to move upon your people from the top of their head, God, to the sole of their feet. Come on, just lift up the Lord. He's worthy to be praised today. Step down in that water. Step down into that anointing. Let the spirit and the power of the Lord begin to move on your life. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. He is worthy to be praised. How many of you love the Lord this morning? Amen. He's worthy to be praised. Go ahead. I want you to just worship him. I want you to just lift him up. Just lift up your hands and begin to worship the Lord. Just praise and worship his name. Amen. I'm going to ask Tasha and him to sing one more little song here. I want you to lift up your hands. Lift up your hearts. Use this as an opportunity to say, God, I am here. God, not my will, but your will be done. Ooh, Sundaramana Sutriya. There are some this morning, you are in that place of indecision. You're in that place to decide to get more committed or less committed. And the Lord is encouraging you this morning to be more committed. The Lord is encouraging you this morning to increase the enhancement of that intimate relationship between you and your Heavenly Father. Begin right now to say, God, here am I. God, right now, if there's anything in me that is a hindrance, if there's anything in me that is keeping me from moving into the excellency of calling that God has given me, then, Lord, I ask you right now to eradicate it. Lord, I ask you right now to cut it out. God, I ask you right now to take it out of me, remove every influence, remove every hold and every bondage that it has had upon me, God. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. And we believe it in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And amen. I want you to lift up the Lord. And sister Tasha's going to sing this song. Just lift up your hearts, lift up your hands. And see, the whole reason for that is say, God, I surrender. God, not my will, but your will. God, not my way, but your way. Let's lift him up and praise him right now. Let's just worship him where we are. Just begin to praise him. Just begin to worship him where you are.
Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain, let it rain, open the floodgates of heaven, let it rain, let it rain, open the floodgates.
Lift up the Lord, he's worthy to be praised. Lift him up, he's worthy.
Open the floodgates. to rest.
Yes, Lord.
Now the heartbeat of heaven, let us hear.
Woo, yes, Lord.
I feel the rain of your love and the wind of your spirit. Now the heartbeat of heaven, let us hear.
Woo, come on now. Lift up your hands and praise.
I feel the rain of your love.
He's worthy.
And the wind of your spirit. Now the heartbeat of heaven. Let us hear.
Come on, church. Let's praise him.
I feel the rain of your love. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it. and the wind of your spirit. Now the heartbeat of heaven, let us hear. I feel the rain of your love and the wind of your spirit. Now the heartbeat.
Open the floodgates of heaven.
Come on, church, lift up your hands. Let's worship and praise the Lord. I don't know about you this morning, but I can feel the anointing of God moving through this place this morning. The Spirit of God is moving in this place. People are being touched. People are getting ministered to. We have people out in the Spirit all over the place because the anointing and the power of God is present here. You know, one thing about Revival of Christ, we don't have a schedule. We don't have an agenda. We're going to come in and be led by the Spirit. And if the Spirit wants praise, praise shall the Spirit get. If the Spirit wants the Word shall the Spirit get. If the Spirit wants people to be touched and ministered to, they shall be touched and ministered to. Amen. Praise the Lord. So just lift up the Lord. He's so worthy. How many of you feel that residue of anointing this morning? Amen. Oh, thank you, Jesus. 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 Just lift him up for just a moment. Sometimes he's worthy to be praised. You know, so often we get so busy in all the things we're doing for the Lord. You know, we get so busy, got to deliver this message, got to have this revival, got to do this, got to do that. You know, sometimes you got to take time to just get into his presence. Sometimes you got to take time to just lift up your hands and surrender. And say, God, here am I. I surrender to you, Jesus. I surrender to you, Jesus. Father, take out of me every element that is contrary to your plan, to your purpose, and to your vision. Father, right now, release an anointing upon your people. Even those that may be watching this morning, touch them right where they are. Touch them, God. Reach your hand out right now, and God will touch you right where you are. Father, let them know how real you are, how true you are. Oh, Rababokosi, Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Come on, church, let's lift him up. He's worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be exalted. This is our Knights of the Lord's Table month. Through the month of October, we celebrate the Knights of the Lord's Table. We celebrate men who stand up to be victorious and spiritually correct in their relationship with God. At the end of this month, we're going to have a tremendous revival. Yes, it's going to be called Restoring the Revelational Roar. Yes, we're going to restore that revelational roar. Coming up at the end of the month, it's going to be a revival that I'm going to be doing in conjunction and side by side with my good brother, Chuck McSweeney from Gainesville, Florida. He's going to be here. We're going to have a great revival, devil busting on two of the nights. So come out, it's going to be a great, great time in the Lord. You know, I'm very blessed. Our church is very blessed. We're so blessed in so many ways. I never want to count our blessings for granted. We are so blessed. God, I am so thankful. I am so thankful, God, for every arrow you put in our quiver. God, I'm so thankful for every element that you've given us, that we might proclaim the good news of Jesus Christ, that we might lift up his word without hypocrisy, without partiality, without compromise, but in power, spirit, and in truth. I'm grateful for that, God. I'm thankful for that, God. You know, church, we've got to come to a place where we stop allowing the influence of the world to tell us how we should conduct our worship and praise unto the Lord. Amen. It's always been odd to me. Why would you go to the world to learn how to worship God when they don't worship God? Amen. Praise God. But what I want to do is I want to see what the Word of God says. I don't want to see what this one says or that one says or this one says. I want to know what thus saith the Lord God. I want to know what the Spirit and the anointing of God says. And let me tell you something. If God says something that disagrees with your flesh, so be it. Let it disagree with your flesh. See, we're confused in this generation. We think if it's an opinion, that makes it true. Just because it's an opinion, don't make it true. You know, I heard somebody a couple weeks back say something that just flabbergasted me. It says, we believe in the truth, not facts. I'm like, excuse me? We believe in the truth, not the facts. Well, then what is your truth based on? I got news for you. My truth is not based on what the world tells me. My truth is not based on what carnality and flesh dictates I must do in order to be popular, in order to fill up a seat. I'll tell you what it is. It's when the voice of God comes in and declares his word, declares his spirit. It's when his anointing moves as it's moved in this place. Well, Brother Vanover, I don't feel the anointing. I don't get touched by the anointing. Oh, I know you don't seek it. Why would you get touched by it? Come on, hear me. You're wanting a three-ring circus. You're wanting God to come up and slap you in the face. God's not about slapping you in the face. God's going to come up and present his presence. You have a choice, either to step down in the river or walk on the side. It's up to you. But as for me and my house, we're getting in the river. As for me and my house, we are excited about what God's going to do. As for me and my house, the world does not dictate my worship. My worship is dictated through intimate relationship with my Heavenly Father, so that when his presence comes upon me, it is not something new. It is something I'm familiar with. Can you say amen? See, maybe the reason you don't think you feel the Spirit is you're not very familiar with the Spirit. Can you say amen? It might be trying to move on you, and you might be trying to justify it or discount it for something. The point is this: if you want God's holy, anointed DNA, you cannot go to something that does not possess his DNA. Can you say praise God? And just because your flesh thinks it's okay, see, this is the one point we got to get to. See, this is where we start playing God and stop letting God be God. We start playing God because we start trying to interpret the word of God to justify whatever opinion, whatever idea we have. But Josephine, I got news for you. It is time that the word of God get preached without hypocrisy, without partiality, straight and powerful, to move your opinion, your ideas out of the way, and let truth be established by the fact of the word of God. The anointing. You know, I hear people come up and say all kinds of crazy stuff. Brother Vanover, God gave me a spiritual thing. He did? Yeah, where's that Bible? Well, it's not in there. You know, it's a developed. No, it's in there. If it ain't in there, you don't need to be doing it. Can you say praise God? We're not here to see Brother Vanover's ministry. We're not here to see Pastor Chris's ministry. We're not here to lift up nobody but Jesus. He said, if I be lifted up, oh, come on, church, I can't hear you. He said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. If we lift up anything other than Jesus Christ, we compromise, we fail. See what we need. I'm going to tell you what we need, and I'm going to shut up. I'm going to tell you what the church needs. We need a good old-fashioned altar appointment. Oh, y'all ain't listening to me. We need to get down to the altar. We can't get back down on our knees. We need to get on our face. We begin to open up our face and cry before the Lord and say, God, I repent of everything that I've ever done that has hindered your movement in me. God, take out of me every personal opinion, every bit of pride and arrogancy. Humble me. On a solid foundation. If you get a good appointment with God at the altar, you might experience his presence. And after you experience his presence, your countenance is going to change. Every time you encounter God, you change. Every time. I love you this morning on this beautiful Sunday morning. You know, I look at what this church has been through. I look at the faith and courageousness that our church has had coming through the pandemic all the way to this point. I'm very grateful and I'm very thankful to God. I'm thankful to God that all of our people are safe and healthy and employed and blessed. Amen. Come on, give the Lord a praise. That's a miracle. That is a miracle in itself right there. God has protected and kept our people safe. Amen. But as much as we've been through, and as busy as we always are for the Lord, every so often, you just need a service like this, where you just lift up your hands. You're just in his presence. He's loving on you, and you're loving on him. Amen? Amen. Praise the Lord. Somebody lift up Jesus. He's worthy to be praised on this beautiful morning. Everybody, let's give Sister Tasha and them a hand. They did a great job. Praise and worship this morning. I'll tell you what I want to do. While you're there, and while we're getting ready to wind down the service this morning, I think we had a dance planned for this morning, and I want to go ahead and have them do it because I like this dance. This is Tasha Cobb. She's got a tremendous song called Not By Might Nor By Power But By My Spirit Saith the Lord. So we do this as an act of worship and praise, an expression of love to our Heavenly Father. So everybody sit back and relax. Here comes our Revival for Christ Club praise dancer.
we do.
We stand in awe of you.
Stand in awe.
We stand.
Not by power, by your spirit, God. Send your spirit,
praise the Lord. That is awesome. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. That is awesome. How many of you know it's by his power? Amen. Praise God. Praise the Lord. We thank you if you are watching us on live stream today. God bless you. Good to have you with us. And check us out Wednesday night. Got another program coming on Wednesday night. Don't forget every Monday and Tuesday, 10 o'clock on the CFAN network. So thank you so much for tuning. God bless. God bless. Amen. All right, praise the Lord. How many of you love the Lord tonight? He is worthy. He is worthy to be praised. Amen? All right.
Hello, my name is Ryan Collin, International Evangelist and Administrative Vice President of Revival for Christ Love International Ministries. We thank you so much for tuning in. And if you would like to support us, there's many ways you can do that. First, you can give us a call at 405-793-1777. Also, you can mail in your support at 1005 Southwest 4th Street in Moore, Oklahoma, 73160. Also, if you have the Cash App, you can donate on there. It's RFC ROAR. That's R-O-A-R. Guys, thanks so much. God bless.